Thank you for being here this morning, and thank you to everyone that's going to be helping out with the program. In just a moment, our veterans are going to enter. Thank you again.
Thank you. welcome to our second annual Willard City Schools Veterans Day program. We are proud to have all of our students together today to celebrate this very special day, which honors the men and women who have served our country, the United States Armed Forces, those who came home to enjoy the peace they earned, as well as those who gave their lives to protect that peace. Willard City Schools welcomes you and thanks you for your service.
History, America's soldiers, sailors, airmen, Marines, and Coast Guardsmen have bravely answered the call to defend our freedom, to aid our friends and allies, and to turn back aggressors. We can never fully repay our debt of gratitude to more than 650,000 American servicemen who died in battle, the 1.4 million who were wounded. However, we can recognize and thank the 25 million veterans still here today. These words are inscribed in the Korean War Memorial in D.C. Our nation honors her sons and daughters who answered the call to defend a country they never knew and people they never met. Those words apply equally to many of our World War I, World War II, Vietnam War, and Gulf War veterans as well. They apply to today's active duty service members, tomorrow's veterans, who are helping to maintain peace throughout the world. Today, it is our privilege to say thank you to all the American veterans, to let them know that we appreciate them for their service and to honor them for their sacrifices. The price of freedom is high. We cannot afford to forget those willing to pay it. Today, we celebrate American veterans for keeping this nation land of the free, and a home of the brave.
Thank you, Mr. Crawford, for those inspiring words. We are thankful to have you as our middle school history teacher, one who abides by these words. You are a great role model for our students. At this time, under the direction of Mr. Christian Watson, we invite the Flashes Marching Band to play the Armed Forces Medley.
Thank you. those who gave the ultimate sacrifice for us will leave a seat of honor on the stage. We honor you, and you will never be forgotten. Please rise for the singing of Taps by our chamber choir, with a special verse by our senior, Gabe Sanchez.
We would like to invite our city mayor, Joe Daniel, to come forward for a reading of the City of Willard Proclamation honoring our veterans.
Good morning. Thank you this morning for allowing me to come here to present this proclamation for our veterans. Whereas since the American Revolution, at least eight generations of American military veterans have established an unbroken commitment to this nation, answering the call to preserve, protect, and defend our freedom. And whereas more than 1 million men and women serving in armed forces of the United States of America have sacrificed their own lives to preserve our way of life. And whereas millions more soldiers, sailors, airmen, and Marines have sustained injury, often catastrophic and permanent, while in the military service of this country. And whereas we owe a tremendous debt to those who are and have served in the defense of this nation. And whereas in honor of these dedicated women and men, we pledge our continued support and appreciation to them. So their sacrifice may stand before the entire world as a tribute to the spirit and determination of a people dedicated to the principles of freedom and justice and democracy. Now, therefore, I, Joe Daniel, Mayor of the City of Willard, Ohio, urge all who read and hear this proclamation to recognize and honor our veterans on Veterans Day and every day. Set forth by my hand this date, the 7th day of November, 2018, signed Joe Daniel.
Mr. Mayor, for your bravery, hard work, and dedication, both as an officer of the law and as mayor of our community, we thank you.
Our featured speaker today is a 1982 graduate of Willard High School and was most recently awarded one of our first Distinguished W Awards for his outstanding service to our country. Upon graduation from Willard High School, Daniel Barnett attended North Central Technical College, obtained his Bachelor's of Science in Business Administration at The Ohio State University, and obtained his Master's degree at Webster University. As a member of the U.S. Army, he has been in many countries throughout his military career, including Panama and Iraq. Colonel Barnett's numerous military decorations include Legion of Merit, Second Award, Bronze Star, Fourth Award, Meritorious Service Medal, Fifth Award, the Army Commendation Medal, Fourth Award, and the Army Achievement Medal, Third Award. In addition to an amazing military career, Mr. Barnett is a loving husband, father, son, and is a new grandfather. He sets an excellent example for our young people. We are excited for him to share his wisdom and inspiration with us today. Please give a warm Flash's family welcome to Willard High School alumni, retired Colonel Daniel Barnett.
Good morning, everybody. It's a real pleasure to be here, and I'd just like to say up front, this is really an impressive display of gratitude. It's not something that you see everywhere these days, but you see it in small, patriotic little towns like Willard. So, on behalf of myself and all the veterans that are here today, I want to thank you for this, because this doesn't happen everywhere. It's just, this is not the norm. So, it's really an impressive thing to see, and I'm blessed to be here today with you, so thank you for having me. Being here brings back a lot of great memories. I spent a lot of time back here in this balcony area on the wrestling team, working pretty hard, trying to train and get better all the time. So being here just is a good thing for me. It's good to be back here and to see folks. And if I don't remember your name, it's not you, it's me. I've been gone for quite a while, so but it's good to be back home. It's an honor and a privilege to be invited back here to share a message with family, friends, with the students here, with my former teachers, former mentors. On behalf of all the veterans that are here, those that are retired or discharged like myself, those that are currently serving, and those that cannot be here on their own behalf to speak for themselves. Veterans of the Army, the Air Force, the Marines, the Navy, and the Coast Guard. A veteran is any person who has served honorably in the armed forces of the United States. Veterans Day is a celebration to honor those veterans for their patriotism, their love of country, and for their willingness to serve and sacrifice for the common good. It's really just as simple as saying thank you to our veterans. And with that, I'd just like to ask everybody that's a veteran in the audience just to stand and be recognized and receive one more round of applause, because you deserve that. So if you're a veteran, please stand. lot to these men and women that just stood up. Veterans Day is a holiday that was born from one of our country's greatest challenges and one of the most traumatic experiences in our nation's history. World War I ended on the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month on 11 November 1918. This Sunday, we observed the 100-year anniversary of the signing of the armistice that ended those hostilities. World War I was called the war to end all wars because the casualties were so horrific that no one ever wanted to repeat the pain associated with such a loss of life ever again. In November 1919, President Woodrow Wilson established the first observances of Veterans Day, which back then was called Armistice Day. Later in 1954, after Americans freed the world from the threat of fascism and secured the Korean Peninsula after a communist invasion, the holiday was officially renamed Veterans Day, set aside to honor all of our nation's veterans. So we have recognized as a nation, we have honored our veterans every November 11th since the year 1919, almost 100 years. And we recognize and thank those that have served both in times of peace and in times of war. Veterans of World War I, World War II, Korea, Vietnam, the Cold War, Operation Desert Shield, Desert Storm, Operation Iraqi Freedom, Operation Enduring Freedom in Afghanistan, and other actions and operations that are too numerous to mention here today. I retired 3 years ago after serving my last tour of duty at Fort Benning, Georgia. It's also where I began my military career in 1988. I live just outside of Fort Benning in Columbus, Georgia. Those that haven't been there, Fort Benning is really an amazing installation. It was created, ironically, out of the need to train forces for World War I, and the post just recently celebrated its 100-year anniversary as well. Its footprint spreads across 182,000 acres. It's enormous. It's the home of the Army's infantry, armor, and cavalry. The U.S. Army trains somewhere between, in the neighborhood of 140,000 soldiers, men and women there every year, 140,000. On any given day, there are 14,000 soldiers. Today, there are 14,000 soldiers training at Fort Benning. They're learning how to be leaders in Ranger School. They're learning how to jump out of airplanes in Airborne School. They're conducting basic training, learning how to be 11 Bravo Infantrymen, or 19 Delta Cavalry Scouts, or 19 Kilo Tank Crewmen. Most of those soldiers are young people, not much older than a lot of you students here in this room today. And one of the most encouraging things for an old soldier like myself is to see your generation serve as well, to step up to the plate and to preserve our freedoms. If you visit a place like Fort Benning, you see that pride and willingness to serve on a daily basis. It's what we do as Americans. We serve and we sacrifice the good of our country and the good of the entire world. There's no doubt that our world would be a much darker place without the sacrifice of our veterans. So if we celebrate Veterans Day this week, thank a veteran for their service, and think about what you can do to serve others as well. It's the legacy that has been laid before you by our veterans. So whether you choose to serve in the armed forces, or you serve as a first responder, or a teacher, or a coach, maybe you volunteer at your church, or you do something to help those that are less fortunate than yourself. Whatever your calling is, use it to the benefit of your community. Say thanks to a veteran for the freedoms that we all enjoy today, and choose to serve and give back to others in some capacity. It's really the best way to thank and honor a veteran for their service. My wife Brenda always helps me get prepared for these things. She told me, you know, she always tells me three things: be good, be brief, and be gone. I think I've been brief, and I'll be gone, and you get to determine whether I'm good. So thank you for having me here today. It's really been a pleasure. It's great to be back.
Thank you, Colonel Barnett, for your inspiring words and your service to our country. We congratulate you on such a rewarding career, as well as being a member of the first class of distinguished W Award winners. Now, we would like to turn your attention to our elementary flashes, grades K through 5, under the direction of Mrs. Kristen Hall, singing God Bless the USA.
For us to express who we are. That is something people should always be thankful for. Veterans made this country free, and they fight for us every day, even though they don't know who we are. And for that, I am truly thankful.
Soldiers stationed away from their family, receiving letters and postcards was a lifeline to those back home. Soldiers waited patiently to hear the words mail call, hoping they would receive any communication from friends and family. Today, with the help of our Flash's family of students and staff, preschool through every grade in high school, as well as several businesses in our community, we are proud to present a Willard Flash's style mail call. We believe it is important to read every veteran's name. When your name is called, please stand if you are able or raise your hand, and a student will deliver your mail. We ask that all audience members hold your applause until the end. Thank you. Abston Norman Air Force. Adams Christopher Air Force. Allen Leonard Army. Alt James Army. Bailey Donnie Army. Banworth Curtis Army. Barkanowitz Juanita Army. Barnett Melvin Air Force. Barnett Ken Army. Barnett Daniel. Bedingfield Al Army. Beery Craig Air Force. Biajewski Ted Army. Blank Fred Army. Boris Tom Army. Brasco Michael Air Force. Brown Ron Army. Buckingham Paul Army. Buckingham Donald Navy. Bus Donald Army. Cable Paul Marines. Carnahan Brian Navy. Carpenter Jim Army. Cassidy Dwayne Army. Casto Kevin Army National Guard. Chase Dick Air Force. Claddy David Marines. Cofer Kelly Army. Coke Calvin Air Force. Coke Randy Marines. Cole Larry Army. Conley Douglas Army. Conley Mitchell Arnold. Crawford Bethany Air Force. Crawford Jim Arnold. Boers Michael Arnold. Seha Gilberta Arnold. Conley Ron Arnold. Crooks Timothy Navy. Daniel Marvin Arnold. Devin West Arnold. Durr Bruce Sr. Etchison Joe Arnold. Elliot George Arnold. Ellis Richard Marie. Enderby Jim Arnold. Forsman Gary Arnold. Fox Jim Arnold. Fox Jim Arnold. Frankert Gene Arnold. Fryman Richard Navy. Glorioso Charles Arnold. Gonzalez Jesus Arnold. Gundrum Fred Arnold. Hammonds Derek Arnold. Harris Jess Arnold. Hulblitz David Arnold. Henry Terry Jr. Air Force. Henry Terry Sr. Navy. Hershiser William Air Force. Hershiser Darren Army. Hicks Ron Marines. Higgins Andrew Navy. Hiltbrunner George Marines. Holden Mark Navy. Holland Jamie Arnold. Helona Jamie Arnold. No, sorry, Helona Lloyd Navy. Posey Brian Marines. Hewlett Edward Air Force. Sergeant First Class Irvine Phelps Jamie Arnold. Jester Barry Air Force. Jester Lee Air Force. Jones Larry Arnold. Keeper Ben Arnold. Kennard Larry Arnold. King Ivan Arnold. Lacer Larry Arnold. LeClaire John Coast Guard. Lindstrom Timothy Navy. Lowry Matthew Coast Guard. Ludbin Jim Army. Lutz Jim Army. Lawrence John Army. Harcher Madeline Air Force. Fink Kenneth Navy. Jenkins Jamie Army. McDonald Larry Army. Mall Oliver Arnold.
Mall Tom Army. Man Charles Army. Martin Clifford Army. McKinley J.D. Army. Miller Ronald Army. Mitchell Artie Army. Maul David Arm. Maul Lynn Arm. Montoni Brian Arm. Nichols Ansel Arm. O'Connor Dennis Army. O'Million Jody Air Force. Owens Robert Navy. Helsing Timothy National Guard Army. Penbreaker Jim Air Force. Pittinger Gary Air Force. Polachek Brad Army. Polachek David Navy. Post Emma Dave Army. Price Victoria Army. Puggett Harvey Army. Puggett Allen Marines. Raymond Matt Marines. Reed Kelly Army. Richard Robinson Navy. Richie Kenneth Army. Robinson Lawrence Army. Robinson Rogers Marines. Robinson William Marines. Rose Jim Marines. Rosbert Ken Army. Ryman Charles Army. Ryman Todd Army. Mosley James Navy. Reed Robert Army / Marines. Reed Richard Army / Marines. Prater Bradley Army. Prater Bradley Army, my apologies. Sally Ronnie Army. Sanders Paul Marines. Shaw Dalton Marines. Schlomer Vince Army / Air Force. Chief Schlatterer Jeremy Navy. Schumacher James Army. Seaman Dean Air Force. Sexton Rick Air Force. Schillinger Todd Air Force. Shook Richard Army National Guard. Shriver Rogers Army. Silcox William Army. Silcox Andrew Marines. Smith Don Air Force. Snipes Ray Navy. Snook Don Army. Snyder Harold Navy. Stevens Eric Air Force. Stevens Delmer Army. Stevens Robert Army. Storts Chuck Army. Strimble Salbert Army. Sykes Brian Army. Tackett Henry Army. Tanner Dale Army. Thompson Robert Air Force. Trimner Royden Army. Tuttle Trim Army. Vanderpool Dennis Army. Vanderpool Roy Army. Walton Fred Army. Ward Robert Army. Weinbrower William Army. Weiss John Senior Army. West Gary Navy. Whetstone Richard Army. White Jim Marines. Wilkinson Jack Army. Willard William Army. Wilson Gary Army. Wilson Tina Army. Wilson Speck Clyde Army. Wolf Kenneth Army. Xander Christopher Navy. Sally Larry Army. Snay Jim Army. Celie Kelly Army. Smith David Air Force. If there is anybody's name who was not called or did not hear, please stand. Anyone who has not received a bag, please stand.
We are fortunate in our community and surrounding areas to have so many military veterans who are willing to answer our nation's call. Veterans followed many different paths after serving, and some of them were led to continue to serve in their community, like our former city mayor, Mr. Todd Schittinger, and WHS graduates current Huron County Sheriff Todd Corbin and city manager Jim Ludman. But serving in the military isn't the only way to support our community. We are lucky to also have so many emergency service personnel and police officers who also serve as role models for our young people, and we thank them for answering that call. Our final podium guest today is the City of Willard Chief of Police, Shannon Chaffin.
Always be grateful for the freedom we have in every region, in our states, and as a country.
live in honor among us or sleep in valor beneath sacred ground. For the past 2 years, Willard High School students have been dedicated to raising money for Honor Flight, which is a national program that sends veterans to Washington, D.C. to tour their monuments. Through our school's efforts on various fundraisers, like Dress Sundays and our 5K Honor Run, we have been able to sponsor 8 Honor Flight seats for a total of $4,000 in just 2 years. Even more special is the opportunity to sponsor heroes from our hometown. Today, we have the honor and privilege of recognizing those who trip our school as sponsors.
Mission number 92, just a few weeks ago, and from Willard, please welcome Barry Jester, Vietnam veteran. Lee Jester, Korean War veteran. And from the next mission, number 93, this Sunday, Don Smith, Korean War veteran. It is our privilege to sponsor your seats and welcome you home. And to those who will be going in the future, we know you will have an amazing trip. At this time, if there are other veterans in the audience who have participated in an honor flight, would you please stand and be recognized?
On the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month of 1918, an armistice, or temporary ceasefire, of hostilities was secured between the Allied nations and Germany in the First World War, then known as the Great War. Unfortunately, the war to end all wars did not, and the United States was soon embroiled in World War II and then the Korean War. In 1954, after lobbying efforts by veteran service organizations, U.S. Congress amended the 1938 Act that had made Armistice Day a holiday, striking the word armistice in favor of veterans. From then on, November 11th became a day to honor American veterans of all wars, which we are honored to celebrate with you today. This Sunday, on November 11th, officially Veterans Day, at 11:11 a.m., communities are encouraged to ring their bells 21 times in remembrance of the 100th anniversary of the end of World War I. Because we will not be in session, we ring our bell today.
Thank you.
Would everyone please, if you are able, and join in the singing of God Bless America, and remain standing for the retiring of our nation's colors.
Please.